I can't believe it's already another year, but the Christmas program's here again. Nice to see it's well attended, just like last year was. I'm going to welcome Henry Lauder up to the stage to read a passage and open this meeting with prayer, and then we're going to sing the first two verses of the First Noel.
I'd like to read from Isaiah 11, the verses 1 to 11. A shoot will come up from the stump of Jesse. From his roots, a branch will bear fruit. The Spirit of the Lord will rest on him, the Spirit of wisdom and of understanding, the Spirit of counsel and of power, the Spirit of knowledge and of the fear of the Lord. And he will delight in the fear of the Lord. He will not judge by what he sees with his eyes, or decide by what he hears with his ears. But with righteousness he will judge the needy. With justice he will give decisions for the poor of the earth. He will strike the earth with the rod of his mouth. With the breath of his lips he will slay the wicked. Righteousness will be his belt, the faithfulness the sash around his waist. The wolf will live with the lamb. The leopard will lie down with the goat. The calf and the lion and the yearling together, and a little child will lead them. The cow will feed with the bear. Their young will lie down together, and the lion will eat straw like the ox. The infant will play near the hole of the cobra, and the young child put his hand into the viper's nest. They will neither harm nor destroy on all my holy mountain, for the earth will be the full of the knowledge of the Lord as the waters cover the sea. In that day, the root of Jesse will stand as a banner for the peoples. The nations will rally to him, and his place of rest will be glorious. In that day, the Lord will reach out his hand a second time to reclaim the remnant that is left of his people from Assyria, from Lower Egypt, from Upper Egypt, from Cush, from Elam, from Babylonia, from Hamath, and from the islands of the sea. I think as a Sunday night Bible study, we've been going through the Minor Prophets, and I think the Men's Society is going through the Minor Prophets as well. I think the Women's Society has done it too in the last year. And when we read through that, we realize, the people of Israel, the strife, the falling away from the Lord all the time, but yet these faithful promises that the Lord has given them. And then as we celebrate Christmas too, we can look forward to that for us as well, because we've often said at Bible study, those Israelites, how could they do that? But we are much the same. Isn't it a wonderful thing that we have a faithful Father who has been faithful to his covenant and has fulfilled that promise also with the birth of our Mediator and Savior? So let's think about that also as we celebrate tonight. Can I now lead you in prayer?
Thank you.
I'd like to invite up the young girl group to sing Offering.
Over the skies of Bethlehem appeared a star. Well, angels sang to lowly shepherds. Three wise men seeking truth traveled from afar, hoping to find the child from heaven. Falling on their knees, they bowed before the humble Prince of Peace. I bring an offering of worship to my King. No one on earth deserves the praises that I sing. Jesus, may you receive the honor that you're due. Oh Lord, I bring an offering to you. The sun cannot compare to the glory of your love. There is no shadow in your presence. No mortal man would dare to stand before your throne. Before the Holy One of Heaven, it's only by your blood, it's only through your mercy, Lord, I come. I bring an offering of worship to my King. No one on earth deserves the praises that I sing. Jesus, may you receive the honor that you're due. Oh Lord, I bring an offering to you. Oh Lord, I bring an offering to you.
Well, that was quite lovely. Next, the young boy group to sing Little Drummer Boy. Wonderfully done. And Carl, great job as a mic stand. Now we're going to sing Away in a Manger, verses 1 and 3. And now invite all the lovely ladies of the ladies' choir to come up and sing your two songs.
Thank you.
All the children of this church must be getting older, because that's the first time I can remember that the ladies went up and it wasn't serenaded by a bunch of screaming kids. So, up next is the anonymous group. No one knows who they are, but we will soon find out.
Be
Well, mystery solved. It's a group of great singers. Let's sing together verses 1 and 7 of God Rest Ye Merry Gentlemen. Up next, we have the children's choir. They're going to do quite the presentation by the looks of things. In between songs, they're going to be reading, and they may be hard to hear, so just follow along in your programs, and then you'll know what's going on.
Thank you.
I'd like to invite Randy Rapp up here to close. And then we're going to sing the closing song, Blessed Be the Tie That Binds. The children are going to sing the first verse, and then we'll, the rest of us, join in for verses 3 and 4. Standing.
Well, it's hard to say anything more than has been said in application or in song. So with that, let's close in prayer.